Hello students, my name is Dr. Ali Raza and today we are going to discuss visual reflexes. We are going to introduce some stimulus into the eye and then look for a response. Remember students, eye being a complex organ have a lot of nerve supply. For example, the extraocular muscles of eye, they are supplied by 3rd, 4th, and 6th cranial nerve. Then when it comes to the sensory supply of the eye, the cornea and conjunctiva are supplied by the ophthalmic division of trigeminal nerve. Then the intrinsic muscle of eye, such as orbicularis oculi muscle, they are supplied by the facial nerve, which is the 7th nerve. And then some smooth muscle such as levator palpebrae superioris, they have autonomic nerve supply. Owing to the special sense of vision, the photoreceptors, they give rise to the optic nerve. So we know that eye is supplied by a lot of nerves, and so this gives us opportunity to test those nerves or neural pathway on the bedside by carrying out some simple reflexes. Remember students, in the center of eye there is an aperture which is called pupil, then surrounding the pupil is our cornea, and then beyond it is the conjunctiva. So we are going to look at the pupillary reflexes, corneal reflexes and conjunctival reflexes. When it comes to the pupillary reflex, the main reflex we are going to see is the light reflex and accommodation reflex. What happens when you throw the light into eye? What happens? There is bilateral constriction of the pupil. Why there is constriction of the pupil? To protect the photoreceptors by limiting the amount of eye light that enters the eye. So we have the light reflex, which could be direct light reflex and the indirect light reflex. In the direct light reflex, we throw eye into one eye and look for the response in the same eye. While in indirect light reflex, what we do, we throw light into one eye and look for the response in the another. And the response being constriction of pupil or decreased diameter of the pupil. What are the neural pathways involved? We throw light, it is sensed by photoreceptors, then the afferents are carried via optic nerve, and then these radiations are carried to the pretectal nucleus, and from the pretectal nucleus the efferents are carried to the oculomotor nerve, which lead to the response of pupillary constriction via its parasympathetic supply. Remember students, pretectal nucleus is the area where crossover takes place and the nerve fibers, they are transmitted to both eyes, and this crossover is responsible for the indirect light reflex. For example, you throw light into the right eye and the left eye pupil will constrict as well. Then we have accommodation reflex. Accommodation reflex is designed by humans to assist them in near vision or focus on the near object. So what happens when you may ask the person to focus on a near object at an arm's length? There are three things which you are going to see, that being pupillary constriction, convergence of the eyeball, and then there is increased convexity of eye lens, so that the dioptric power of lens also increases. The first two things, that being constriction of pupil and convergence of eyeball, you can examine clinically. What neural pathways are involved in this reflex? When you ask the subject to focus on near object, photoreceptors are stimulated, afferents are carried via optic nerve. However, the main difference occurs in the central nervous system, where this time the radiations are carried to the midbrain. Then from midbrain, the efferents are carried via oculomotor nerve, as well as some supply is given to the extraocular muscle to support the convergence of eyeballs. We have cornear and conjunctival reflex. Cornear and conjunctival reflex are designed to protect the eyes from the harmful stimulus. Remember, these areas are very sensitive. So whenever any harmful or irritating object is introduced into the eye, there is bilateral blinking to prevent the harmful object from entering the eyes. So in this case, what happens when you touch the cornea or conjunctiva? Touch receptors are stimulated, the afferents or the sensory supply is carried via the ophthalmic division of trigeminal nerves, from where in the central nervous system it is transmitted to the pons, and from pons the efferents are carried via facial nerve. The facial nerve supplies orbicularis oculi muscles, which are concerned with the closure of eyes. Bilateral blinking happen so that the orbicularis oculi muscle contract and lead to the closure of eyelids. Students, let's look at the apparatus required for carrying out these visual reflexes. The apparatus is really simple. We have torch to throw light into the eye, then we have a pencil for assisting the focus on a near object, then we have sterile gauze or cotton piece, and then there is a cardboard. Now we are going to use this apparatus and carry out the reflexes on our subject. Students, let's proceed with the examination. As always, the preliminary steps being approaching the subject from the right side, building rapport with the subject and taking their consent. Assalamualaikum, मेरा नाम डॉक्टर अली रजा और मैं आपकी आंखों का मुआयना करना चाहता हूँ. क्या आप मुझे इस मुआयने की इजाज़त देते हैं?
जी.
इस मुआयने में मैं ये करूँगा कि मैं आपकी आंखों में रोशनी डालूँगा और उसके बाद मैं आपकी आंखों में देखूँगा कि उसकी रोशनी डालने की वजह से आपकी आंखों ने कैसे रिस्पॉन्ड किया. स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स टेस्ट फॉर द pupillary eye reflexes. We are going to ask the patient to cover his left eye, and then we are looking for the direct eye reflex in the right eye. आप बराए करम जो अपनी बाएं आंख है उसको बंद करके हाथ रख लें और दाएं आंख को खुला रखें. अब अपनी दाएं आंख को खुला रखेंगे आप. So what we are going to do, we are going to introduce the light reflex, and remember, introduce the light reflex from the periphery toward the center. Don't just throw the light into the center. Bring the light from the periphery into the focus. So, आप अपनी आंखें खोल लें. Now, I'm going to introduce the light into the via periphery and look at the diameter of the pupil changing. आप प्लीज अपनी आंख खोले रखें. Students, let's focus again. Now, as soon as the light comes into the focus, the pupil constricts. अब आप अपनी दाएं आंख को कवर कर लें और बाईं आंख खुली रखें. Again, bring the light from the अपनी आंख खोलें, please. चलिए. So, now look at the response of the pupil. The pupil is constricting. Now let's go for the indirect light reflex. इसमें आपने ये करना है कि आपने अपनी जो हाथ है वो अपने नाक के ऊपर इस तरह रख के दोनों आंखों के दरमियान रखें इस तरह. ठीक है जी. So now let's go for the indirect eye reflex. अब अपनी गर्दन सीधी करें. Now we are going to throw the light into the right eye and look for the response in the another eye. तो मैं रोशनी जो है वो इस आँख में डालूंगा और देखूंगा उस तरफ. ठीक है. तो focus on this eye. अब अपनी आंखें खुली रखें. Now look, when you throw the light into the right eye, the opposite pupil is constricting as well. आप अपना ये वाला हाथ दरमियान में रखें एंड देन दोनों आंखें खोलें. नाउ
both the pupils are equally constricting.
We are going to perform the accommodation light reflex. आपके सामने जो दीवार है आप उस पर फोकस करें. Ask the subject to focus on a non-illuminating object at a distance and then introduce an object at an arm's length or a distance up to 10 to 12 inches. अभी बात फोकस करें. अब मैं आपके पास ये पेंसिल लेके आऊंगा. अब आपने इस पे फोकस करना है. So remember students, there was convergence of eyeballs as well as the pupillary constriction. There is third response as well, which is the increased convexity of eye lens. However, this can't be seen clinically. Now we are going to perform the corneal and conjunctival reflex. What happens in this reflex? We introduce the stimulus of touch and we touch the cornea as well as conjunctiva and then look for the response, which would be bilateral blinking of eye. Remember students, while doing this reflex, always ensure that all the apparatus is sterilized, since the cornea, due to its relatively avascular structure, is very fragile, and introduction of any germs or bacteria into the cornea can lead to formation of corneal ulcers, which would be harmful to the patient. And remember, while doing corneal reflex, don't touch the center, just touch at the corneal conjunctival junction or at the periphery. So I have sterile cotton buds. अपनी आंखें खोल लें. नाउ टू टेस्ट फॉर द कॉर्नियल रिफ्लेक्स आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू टच एट द कॉर्नियल कंजक्टाइवल जंक्शन एंड आंखें खोल के रखें एंड देर इज बायलैटरल ब्लिंकिंग ऑफ द आई. आंखें खोलें आप पहले. सो आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू डू इट एट द कॉर्नियल कंजक्टाइवल जंक्शन एंड look at the rapid blinking response of the patient. Now for the conjunctival reflex, abina aage call ke rakhe hain, look at the blinking response and then do it bilaterally. Aankhe khole hain. Now look at the blinking response in corneal as well as conjunctival reflex. So we can safely infer that the corneal and conjunctival reflex are intact in the patient.